After the first ever Howard Stern Film Festival was announced, thousands of entries from all over the country began flooding the Howard TV offices. 9 lucky finalists were selected from over 2,100 entries to compete for the grand prize worth over $30,000. Celebrities, fans, show regulars, and the cast of the show have gathered as the very first Howard Stern Film Festival is about to get underway.
We're expecting a very, 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 very tight load-in and show bill with minimal rehearsal.
God damn it, Scott, this is not the schedule I was given.
Yes, it is.
How many times?
What's not going on? Last minute things, we're cleaning out the garbage, we're making it look good. We don't want it, we gotta get it out of here, we gotta get it right.
We got the seating chart for everybody in the house, so I'm just trying to figure out where the judges are gonna sit on this table.
This is where we cut the show. So our director and TV are going to be just basically kicking the shots.
Everything that's on the big screen comes from this truck, from these fingers. And if they screw up, we cut their fingers off.
We have 3 more hours to get this done. Be ready for the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2006 Howard Stern Film Festival. Joining us tonight, Fred Norris, Crackhead Bob, Gary Delabate, Bubba the Love Sponge, High Pitch Eric, Yucko the Clown, Robin Ophelia Quivers, the director of Old School, Todd Phillips, Richard Christie, Benji Bronk, actor and comedian Richard Belzer, Ralph Sorella, the host of tonight's events, Artie Lang, and the man who made this film festival possible, Howard Stern.
Howard!
Welcome to the red carpet at the first annual Howard Stern Film Festival. Limos, Lear Jets, you name it, they're getting here any way they can. And I'm joined by the lovely Joan Rivers. Joan, how you doing?
I am so thrilled to be here. It's just like a big Hollywood premiere. Hollywood came to New York City tonight just for Howard. I'm so happy. And there's going to be a lot of tramps. I saw them all over parading around with their boobies and their body paints. I'm so thrilled.
So Joan's ready to go. I'm ready to go. Here they come, folks. Feeling about your movie going into tonight?
I'm still feeling confident. No matter how many people sling arrows and stones at it, I think we have the best film that's going to be up there tonight, except with the exception of the people who send in their own competitive films.
Gary, you look terrific.
How are you?
I'm great. Who are you wearing, Gary?
Who am I wearing? Prada.
Wonderful.
And what are you doing during the show? Anything?
I just got a job yesterday. I'm very excited.
Which is?
I'm going to be presenting the winners of the Staff Awards.
There's a lot of controversy on today's show about you kind of trashing Robin and Fred's movie. Do you think that's going to come true tonight?
You know what? I could care less.
Well, we're happy you're here. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
Great to see you.
Best dressed right here. Bubba the Love Sponge joining us.
Bubba,
how
are
you doing?
Thank you, Joan. Thank you very much.
Bubba,
how are you today?
Who's on your arm there?
This is my fiance, Heather.
Heather, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Great boobies. God bless.
How do you feel about your movie tonight? Are the meat and vegetables going to bring it home for you?
I hope so. You know, I worked really hard at it, and I want to thank Robin Quivers. She was a big inspiration. You know, if she didn't shove meat and vegetables in her vagina, I wouldn't have anything to present tonight, so.
Nice. Sal and Christine, enjoy the night. Big black cloud just entered the room.
Oh,
that
boy.
Means Scott the engineer
Where is
here.
It? Watch out, it might be raining. Hold
Scott,
on.
How are you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling great. This is unbelievable. This is like, a Hollywood premiere.
How'd you get here tonight?
A cab.
And what did the guy say to you when you got in?
He's like, well, what the hell are you supposed to be?
Todd Phillips, the great director.
Thank you.
Todd, how you doing?
Good. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Howard TV?
Yes.
You've been to a ton of film festivals.
I have.
Where does this one rank in terms of the red carpet so far?
At the very bottom, definitely. This is great. I'm really excited about it.
How do you
this
feel?
Is like, you know, the Cannes Film Festival for degenerates.
High Pitch, where'd you get the size 60 tuxedo that we heard so much about?
Well, the jacket's a 60, my waist is a 56.
Ah, I see.
So I lost some weight.
You're looking sharp.
Thank you, you too.
Thank you. Have a good time.
Thank you.
You look wonderful.
Thank you. Show you look beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Sure you can. Alpha Boy, quick question. Yeah, did you shit your pants tonight? Because
no.
I know that's happened before.
No, I make sure everything nice and clean.
So, were you worried with all your calls this week that maybe you may not get the ticket?
No, I wasn't worried about that at all. I just wanted to roll with a hockey.
Robin, how are you feeling tonight?
I feel very good. This is very exciting.
You feeling confident about the movie even after today?
Feeling so confident about the movie. We did a stellar job. We didn't just do a good job. We did a stellar job. We did something different than everybody else, and they're all jealous. That's why we're getting all this heat.
Now, how does this red carpet compare to all the other red carpets you've gone down?
This is a lot of fun. This is a lot of fun. Usually we're being screamed at, why did you do something wrong? Now people are saying, oh, isn't this wonderful? What kind of films are going to be here, and what kind of judge are you going to be?
And this is your day, Richard Christie?
Yeah, I was going to say, are you going to talk
my
about
goodness.
Today right here?
The new item. Right. Hello, darling.
You saw it here first.
We're supposed to be keeping this quiet.
Yeah, this is hush hush.
We won't say a word.
The reason we're all here, the great Howard Stern. First annual Howard Stern. How you feeling, Howard?
About 10 minutes ago, John Hine used to work. I think he was a stockbroker or something. Now he's the entire channel.
I appreciate that. How you feeling?
Very handsome.
Oh, thank you.
What a surprise, Ralph! Right next to Howard.
Everybody. Oh, look who finally woke up after 6 months.
This is exciting. I can't wait for the night. I can't wait to go see the film.
How do you think your film's going to do?
I think my film will play swell.
Now, is it going to be weird with Artie hosting and you sitting back a little bit?
Well, I'm going to be in there enough that I'll have enough attention. You know me, I'm never more than 5 minutes away from doing the film.
Ladies and gentlemen, now performing Red Peters.
They say I can't say these things. Oh, yeah. They tell me I can't say these things. Oh, no. Things like suck my dick, pull my prick. Stick it up your fucking ass. Fuck you, blow me, blow me, blow me, blow me, ooh. They say I can't say these things. Oh, yeah. They tell me I can't say these things. Oh, no. Things like fuck that shit, piss your pants, lick my motherfucking balls, cocked it ass, fuck, blow me, suck you, blow me. Why can I say these things? Things people say every fucking day. Yeah. How's everyone doing? Who says I can't say these things? Oh, yeah. Things like suck your dick, pull my prick, stick it up your fucking ass. Fuck you, blow me, blow me, blow me, blow me. Yeah. Right on, everybody!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the fabulous Howard Stern Film Festival, where you, the ordinary listeners, were given the chance to make an incredible movie about, what else? Something related to Howard Stern and his show. Will we see movies with Gary the Retard battling the flu?
I'm retarded, you jerk! I'm so retarded, flu!
An epic about Baba Booey's teeth. A romantic scene with Mr. X and Robin Quivers.
Look at the way that candlelight shine upon your breasts. It's like the moon going down on the Himalayas, baby.
Or John the Stutterer at his best. Maybe an erotic sex scene with high-pitch Eric.
Hi, Daddy! Look at me!
Or maybe everyone's favorite whackpacker, Beetlejuice.
Say people around you, and they're all abasing you. You just have to get it out of that.
We've weeded through the crap. And now we're down to the best films. And at the end of the night, one lucky fan will be taking the top prize of over $30,000 in cash and prizes. And now, the man that the Howard Stern Film Festival was named after, Howard Stern!
I'm seeing a lot of great people around here. I'm seeing the great Ned over there and the whole Bubba crew. I don't know how many people got to listen to us today, but I've got to tell you something. Never would I have imagined just 4 short months ago that we would be sitting in a studio in the middle of Manhattan, shocking the balls and shocking the puss. And after all, isn't that what satellite radio is all about? My friends, this is a great, great night. After all of the experts said, well, he's got to get 1 million people in order for this thing to be successful. 3.5 months into this thing, we've got 4 million people who have followed us over to Sirius Satellite Radio. This is a great night. And I must tell you something, I'm having a blast. This is the most fun I've had in my entire career. I want to thank Howard Television for the creativity and the great Howard Television crew. What a great night they have in store for us. So many great people here who have helped to put these channels together, and I'm ready to begin the night. So let me officially welcome everyone here. Good evening, and welcome to the Howard Stern Film Festival. A film festival dedicated to subjects about me. Hey, Yucko, how you doing, pal? All right? Everything's fine. Let's face it, we're all here tonight for one spectacular reason.
I love you, Howard!
Oh, yeah, we're going to have fun later at the after party, baby. Don't worry, we're going to shock the puss. It's okay. Anyway, so let me just remind you that every film is about us, but really it is about you. We're here to discover real talent. We received over 2,000 films, and tonight you're going to see the top 9 short films made by some very talented aspiring filmmakers. And their goal is to entertain, inspire, and thrill you, and nothing is off limits. I assure you none of these have been censored. And after we see the films, the judges will cast their votes. Our judges here tonight are a diverse group, which is hard to believe because we've never attracted a diverse group before. Some of these judges are actually accredited. Some of these people have actually directed films. Some of these people have even been on TV. These are great film critics. In fact, some of them will be working at Burgerville with Gary the Retard after tonight because they're finished in show business. Now, seriously, these judges have come here tonight with one main purpose in mind: to pick the winning film in the Howard Stern Film Festival so they can walk off with the big cash and prizes. Are you ready to meet the judges? Okay. Our first judge is Richard Roper, an actual film reviewer. Cancer is his friend because it killed Gene Siskel and has given him a career. You know it and I know it. When Gene died, Richard got the job of working with Roger Ebert, and actually Richard is quite handsome, and if I were gay, I would invite him to spend the night with me on Brokeback Mountain, and I told him that today on the show. Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Roper, thank you for being here tonight. I'm thrilled that he's here. Oh, Richard's here.
I'm here. I'm actually here.
Richard looks like a young Don Johnson. He decided not to shave tonight.
That's exactly right.
It's okay. I want to thank you, Richard, and welcome.
Thank you, Howard. You're right, though. My career is over. In fact, next week, Ebert and High Pitch will be making its debut. I've been replaced.
Very good. I love that. Let me just say that our next judge was an NYU film student who made documentaries that were powerful. They were raw, and they were inspirational. And then he directed Old School and Road Trip and Starsky and Hutch. I saw those films. What the hell happened to this man's integrity, I want to know. What it is, actually, is you can't get laid being a documentary filmmaker. And now he's here with us, Todd Phillips. The great Todd Phillips, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Howard.
Todd, is there anything you want to say? You're actually a guy who has directed films. I mean, after all, what are you doing here tonight?
It's just a pleasure to be here. I'm excited. It's like the Cannes Film Festival for degenerates.
Yeah! And aren't we proud?
And
you know, it's funny, you say degenerates, and I look in the audience and I see Bob Levy making out with Richard Christie, and you're absolutely right. That
Thank
is true.
You. I'm just
Why? Most people know this judge because he has one testicle, and I'm not talking about Lance Armstrong. This one testicle judge is a friend of mine. He's a great man. He plays Detective Munch on Law & Order Special Victims Unit. He is Richard Belzer. He's been dropped on his head by Hogan. And maybe that's why he's here tonight. The great Richard Belzer. Richard.
Yes, Howard.
Richard, you've been with the show for so many years. I want to thank you for that, for always being loyal to us. And we welcome you here tonight, and we look forward to your commentary if you don't fall asleep from all the quaaludes you take.
First of all, it's heroin.
Oh, it's heroin. That's right.
And it keeps me barely awake, so I'll be all right.
All right, Richard Belzer, everybody. Next, a woman who needs no introduction. I love her. If I say Big Mocha Mammaries, who do you think of? If I say 14 cats and 3 houses, who do you think of? If I say sex with meat and vegetables, who do you think of? If I say Master Cleanser Diet and the most popular female radio personality on terrestrial and satellite radio combined, who do you think of? She is the pride of Baltimore, Maryland. Ladies and gentlemen, Robin Ophelia Quivers.
Thank you for dressing up and coming out to our first film festival ever. Thank you, Howard, for one bad introduction after another. We didn't want to come out after hearing your introductions.
Well, I want to give credit where credit's due. Fred Norris wrote every one of these introductions, and I'm proud of him. There he is, the great Fred Norris.
But it's great to be here. We're looking forward to seeing some great films.
Hey, this is a classy film festival. What's with the tick comment?
And so, without further ado, let's get started.
Well, with that, Robin, thank you. I want to introduce to you the man who coined the expression, Wah, I did coke and I got kicked off Mad TV. Wah, they made me wear a pig costume and I was humiliated. Wah, Tom Cruise yelled at me because I was a lousy actor. Wah, a hooker made me pay her $500 after a night of sex. Wah, my girlfriend dumped me because I wouldn't see a shrink for my addictions to food, drugs, booze, and gambling. Wah, my daddy fell off the roof and broke his neck. Here he is. All right, I went too far. I went too far with that. I'm sorry. This man has appeared in such classic films as Dirty Work, The Bachelor, Old School, Elf, and of course, the greatest film of all, Super Twink. Yeah. Here he is, Artie Lang, everybody. The great.
Me. Wah! Wah! I might have to sell one of my Hamptons houses. Wah! Motherfucker, that $500 was the best money I ever spent. So, my tux didn't fit. Yeah. I'm wearing the same corduroys I wore at a Rush concert in 1981. But it's cool because we're at the Howard Stern Film Festival, motherfucker! And because we had such a good turnout here, they had to cancel the David Lee Roth Film Festival. What a fucking shame. This is our greatest and classiest idea ever. This is our greatest idea, I think, since someone thought up weighing all of high-pitch Eric's shit. We want to present Howard Stern-type movies. For instance, we wanted to give you our own version of Brokeback Mountain starring George Takei and Ralph Sorella. But Takei heard about his co-star and he said, "There's no way I'm working with that fucking fag." Look at our judges, Howard Stern, Todd Phillips, Richard Belzer, Robin Quivers. Who says Hollywood is run by Jews and blacks? Todd Phillips is here. Todd directed me in Old School. How about a hand for Todd, man? Todd is the only director I've ever worked with who's still in show business. Richard Roper's here, the great critic. Yeah, I'm going to get you back for some reviews right now, cocksucker. Richard Roper brought a date tonight, and he says the date is his girlfriend, and that's good news for me because that means I'm not the only one tonight with a beard. I'm sorry, Richard. We know you're not a fruit. Come on, look at it. I don't want to say Richard's nerdy, but he makes John Hine look like a young Sean Connery. If a pair of black rimmed glasses with white tape in the middle fucked John Hine, the kid would look like Richard Roper. Richard in the paper in Chicago called me homophobic because of my queer eye for the straight guy. You guys saw me on Queer Eye for the Straight Guy, huh? That's the last time I mixed liquor and homosexual. It's hard hanging around with five gay guys all day because you always feel you have to adjust the conversation so they can relate to it, you know? You're with five gay guys and you go, "Yes, sir, the other day I was playing football. I mean sucking dick." Fire! Yeah!
I love you,
Marty. I love you too, eh? It's always a dude, it's never a chick. If I fucked plumbers, I'd be getting laid constantly. Wah! Wah! I gotta fuck plumbers. Wah!
Homo!
Homo says what? I'll tell you, let me talk about my favorite whack packer, because they're here tonight. Jeff the Drug Guru. "I didn't shit my pants, it was a blister. Why are you guys picking on my mother? Wah! Could you lend me $1,000? Here's my favorite Kuro story of all time. Remember on the E! Show when Jeff was handcuffed to that chick? And the first time Kuro had to take a shit, he goes into the bathroom to shit, and the chick is handcuffed to him, and while he's shitting, she's spraying like Aquanet, whatever the fuck will cut through a satanic smell. And Kuro's merciless. He goes, "Gear up, this is a three-flusher, bitch." That's the Howard Stern Show, yeah. I'm going to get off, but I just want to say, after this gig, I got a lot of great opportunities in show business. Because of tonight, I'm going to host next year's Oscars. Thank you very much. And I want to try out one of my jokes, my opening joke. Tell me if it's a little too edgy for the Oscars. Richard, you'll be able to help me with this. Katie Holmes and Tom Cruise are here. It's great to see them. I saw Katie and Tom kissing each other before on the lips, and I yelled out, "Hey, Katie, how does John Travolta's cock taste?" Just kidding. Nobody's gay. We don't want to get sued. John Travolta's not gay. All right. We ready? Are we ready to roll with the Film Festival Award? That's my time. Come on. Hey, Rita.
I'm just going to. It's nice to be with you, you son of a bitch.
Fuck you, Rita. Go back to your retarded dressing room.
Go back home.
Seriously, Gantz, what are you going to do here? This ain't the Special Olympics. Jesus, God, we... Doug Goodstein negotiated. We got to be out of here at 10. The Kiwanis Club has a meeting. Gary the retard. It's good to see you, retard. Okay, the first item up tonight, Howard, being a good friend that he is, was so nice to me. Let me do this. I have a movie coming out this summer called Beer League. And there you go. And tonight you're going to see the exclusive trailer, the world premiere of the Beer League trailer. So enjoy.
Be honest with me, Artie. The only reason you like me is because I fuck you.
Not at all. I mean, it's awesome.
All right, listen up. Anybody who doesn't do a pregame shot with me right now is a fucking pussy.
For Artie DeVanzo.
The enters today's game.
Blood alcohol content of twice the legal limit.
Life has always been.
Oh, shit.
A swing.
Not today, asshole.
And a miss.
Hey, I'm not one to start trouble.
Oh, my God, you fat fucking liar.
Look at yourself. You're an unemployed drunk. And you still live with your mother.
I made tiramisu. You kids want some?
No, Mom. Go back inside.
It's in the fridge. You change your mind.
Got nothing.
Hardy, what exactly do you have against my cousin?
Oh, well, number one, he's a prick. Number two, he's a cop. Number three, he's a dick.
When I was in the joint, I fucked guys bigger than you.
What the hell are we waiting for? Hey, did Dirt just say he used to fuck guys?
So next year, one of you teams is going to have to play in a different league. You jerk off the side and on the field.
Dude, all we got to do is practice.
Jesus Christ! Practice is for fags. Hey, are we done here? Because I'm losing my buzz.
Now.
My softball team won this league 4 years in a row. Going on five.
Oh, my God. I can't wait to go home and get high.
They're getting serious.
I don't want any of you to tell you. Drink it out of my water bottle.
Off-on-ball.
About softball.
Now that the games mean something, we'll be great.
Good job.
You're out.
Good job.
Sex.
Congratulations. You found your soulmate.
Unbelievable.
Drinking.
Wow. How much did you drink, motherfucker?
And...
All who is front and center, time to rape the bachelor. Come on! Who's got a beard?
What the fuck is going on in here?
Shit.
Hey, black guy, hook me up with some coke, will you?
This summer...
Kind of reminds me how I'm going to miss playing for this team.
It ain't over till it's over. I think we got a shot.
Step up.
Now we're looking like a team!
Way to go, fuckhead!
Shape up.
Oh, my dear Lord.
And sober up.
Last night I had a dream that I killed every single one of you guys.
Relax, Dave. Hey, easy, Dave, huh?
Artie Lang, Ralph Macchio, Cara Buono, Anthony DeSando, with Laurie Metcalf and Seymour Cassell.
These walls are completely soundproof.
Yeah,
of course.
Really?
Would I lie to you?
All right, I'm almost there. Almost there. Not quite yet. Almost there. Almost there. Grab my balls!
Beer League.
How about a toast, huh?
Toast my ass. I gotta piss so bad I could drown a horse.
All right, that put a damper on a toast.
Pinch my nipples. Punch me in the back. Harder. Harder. That's too hard.
Beer League this summer. All right, let's get going. You ready? Yeah. There's a lot on the line tonight. We have some great prizes for the top three winners. The third place winner will get over $4,500 in cash and prizes. The second place winner will get over $11,000 in cash and prizes. And the grand prize winner will get over $30,000 in cash and prizes.
Holla.
Yeah.
Holla.
Including $15,000 in cash, Avid editing software with a Hewlett-Packard operating system, Melody Vision music composing and scoring for their next film, like there's going to be a next film, and Final Draft scriptware What? Final Draft Scriptwriter Software. I don't have computers. Final Draft Scriptwriter Software, all right? So it's good prize. Let's hear it for our 9 finalists who are all here in the front row. Get up and take a bow, guys. There's a bunch of future nerd kids right there. The judges will rate each film, giving it a numerical score. At the end of the night, when the votes are tallied, Howard will announce the winner. But right after we see each of the finalist films, you'll hear what the judges thought of each of them. So sit back and enjoy. Without further ado, here are all the movies that made the finals for the Howard Stern Film Festival. Enjoy it, guys.
Warning, some of the films you're about to see may involve language, content, and themes of an adult nature. But then again, this is the Howard Stern Film Festival. So what else would you expect?
Finalist number 1, The Mating Call by Edda Mae Chamberlain from Fullerton, California.
Honey, I'm sorry you're sick.
Ugh.
It's funny, you don't have a fever. This is the third time this month you've been sick. Have you been taking your vitamins?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Listen, I'm going to take your car so I can listen to Howard on the satellite, okay? Okay. Now get some rest.
Thank you. Finalist number two, Tito Stern, Left Behind, by Eric Connor from Los Angeles, California.
Yes, Howard Stern sodomized me. Frequently. What hurt most of all was that he forgot about me.
We're here with Tito Stern, the puppet who claims to have invented the genius that is Howard. Tito, when did you and Howard first meet?
40 years ago. Howard and I used to perform all over Roosevelt.
Anyone can mash potatoes! Where does Batman take a shower?
You suck!
In the Batroom!
You're awful, half-cheer boy.
Will my mother find me amusing?
Your mother's a neurotic freak! Howard sucks!
I told you not to be stupid, you moron!
Howard sucks! Howard sucks! Howard sucks!
Yeah,
Howard
he
sucks.
Did suck. Then Tito took over. You're mine now. You're my possession. Take what I give you. Yes. Yeah. This is better than rejuvenation.
When did your relationship with Howard change?
The second he discovered vagina.
The establishment. Nixon's problem is that he thinks the American people are incapable of smelling a rat.
Moist.
Why are you so conservative?
Leslie, I think you're really groovy. And maybe...
How about a trip to second base, you dirty, spit-covered whore?
Oh, fuck you! You ain't giving me the clap.
It's the puppet, it's not me.
Oh. Did you mess your pants?
It's only because I like you.
I would rather hook up with that hideous puppet than you, hook-nosed bastard.
This is all your fault.
That's the last I saw him. Next thing I know, he's the king of all mediocre. That fucker. If it wasn't for me, he'd still be telling Batman jokes. And all I could do was sit and listen.
I tell you, Robin, I love the Gary puppet. It brings me so much joy. It's better than all the lesbians in China.
The Gary puppet. Puppet this, puppet that. What about Tito? Don't film that. Sid, don't film that. Get the fuck away from that, you stupid bitch!
So, where can we find Tito Stern nowadays?
I still perform around town. I'll have you know I just did a private show for some rich guy. Les Boone something.
Do you ever think you'll see Howard again?
A puppet can dream. Hey, slut. Once you go puppet, you never go back.
Prude.
What's the difference between an 8-ball and my nuts? $5. Put your hand wherever you want. Best deal in town. Just please cut your nails.
Knock, knock. Knock, knock. Knock, knock.
Can somebody say who's there?
Puppet here. Puppet here. Working hard for the money.
Fucking Howard.
Dino!
Dino! Ha! Can you spare a nickel and some clean boxer shorts?
Eat me.
I got one for you. Where does Batman take a shower?
In the back room.
Oh, you're looking great. You haven't changed a bit.
Howard, you look terrible. How'd you lose $500 million?
Ah!
both.
Finalist number 3, Blood on the Tissues by James Gonzalez from Las Vegas, Nevada.
Probably in your purse or something.
I'm looking in my purse. Oh, here they are.
Oh, there they are.
Don't be a jerk, go. So what are you gonna do tonight?
I don't know. Nothing.
Don't forget to put the alarm on. I forgot again last night. Clean that shit up.
All right.
Welcome to a Howard 100 News special, Tissue Time, Bedtime Stories with Happy Endings. And now, Hostess Heidi Cortez.
Hey guys, thank you for joining me tonight. I'm Heidi Cortez and it's Tissue Time, where we can jack off together, where we can come together as one. Get ready, get your lubrication of choice, socks, a dirty shirt, whatever it might be. I recommend tissues with lotion. I hope you guys will play along with me. Oh God, I'm so horny tonight. I'm gonna take off my top right now. Oh, I just wanna arch my back. Oh God, and spread my legs. Oh God, I'm feeling my breasts right now. Oh my God, my boobs are so big. Oh my God, I'm sticking my hands down my pants right now. Oh God, it feels so good.
What the hell am I doing? Thank you, Howard. Thank you.
I wish I had Manny here with me right now. I would love to come right now. Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm gonna take off my pants right now. Oh God. My pants are around my ankles. Oh my God, I wish you were here with me. Take advantage of me. Oh. Yeah, do it. Do it. Do it. Oh God, it feels so good. Oh shit. Oh my God, I think I'm gonna come. Oh yeah, give it to me. Give it to me. Oh my God. Oh my God. I hope you guys got off. I know I did. If you guys are ready for another hot session, stay tuned after the break as I get really naughty. Tissue Time will continue after these words on Howard 100.
Tissue Time. Bedtime Stories with Happy Endings will continue on Howard 100.
Finalist number 4, radio play by Scott Masterson from Salem, Massachusetts.
Purposes. But President Kennedy says that any nuclear weapon is a threat to peace, and that the greatest danger
CQ,
would be to do nothing.
CQ, does anyone read me? CQ, CQ, does anyone copy? Anybody? CQ, does anyone read me? CQ, does anyone copy? CQ.
Hello?
This is Howard. Who's this?
Fred.
Where do you live, Fred?
Connecticut.
I was in Connecticut once. Do you like it?
Yes.
You're not very talkative, are you, Fred? I'm here. This is Howard. Who's this?
My name's Robin. I live in Baltimore. What about you?
Long Island. Fred's on the same frequency. He's in Connecticut. Say hi, Fred.
Hi.
Hi, Fred.
So, what do we do now?
Robin, do you have, boobies?
Not yet. I'm beginning to think I'll never have them.
So, what's happening, Robin?
Well, high tension continues over the Soviet missiles discovered in Cuba. German police have occupied Der Spiegel offices in Hamburg. And Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf has had a strong opening this week on Broadway.
I took the biggest poop today. It was huge.
I'm serious. I thought I ate the family dog. I didn't know what happened, but the toilet bowl was almost overflowing.
You should be proud of yourself.
I am. That's exactly what it sounded like. Fred, how'd you know?
That is, quite impressive.
I know. I wanted to shape it all into a statue of my butt. Don't get me wrong. I love my dad. But he's always calling me stupid and stuff. I heard that there's some girls out there that actually like other girls instead of boys. There's this retarded kid in my school. I asked him what 2 + 2 was, and he said red. I think everyone should start having midgets as pets. They could get the paper, your slippers. It'd be great. Cheerio. I am king of this frequency. Any opposed to me will be destroyed.
What is thy name, king?
I am King Poopy Pants, and you are all slaves to my stench.
What are you doing in there, you moron? Get to bed.
Howard, you there?
Sorry, guys. I've got to go.
That's okay. Maybe you will talk in the future. Bye, guys.
Thank you.
Finalist number 5, Trapped in the Attic by Chris Pitchford from San Jose, California.
Hey, Ben.
Hey.
Hey now. Welcome to the show. I think we got some ass play for you here today. But first, let me paint you a picture. Artie, laying face down in an empty pizza box. No, Fred, it's too early to take a commercial break. You know the rules when I take this off.
Please don't kill me. Oh my God, I think that man's dead.
Shh. It'll be okay. It's okay, Fred.
My name is not Fred. My name is Eric. You've got the wrong guy.
For Christ's sake, you've got the wrong guy!
Music? Music. How about that one, Artie? Fred decides to open his mouth to remind us that his name is Eric. Let me bring out our first guest. Sitting here completely nude. Looking so hot. You're so hot. What I wouldn't do to you if I was single. Oh, I'd just take you and God damn it, Gary. What have I told you about ruining the bit? You horse-tooth jackass, your ugliness is killing the mood with Jenna. That's better. So I've got a crazy idea. Sexy, how does that feel? Tell me how that feels. Oh my God, you look great.
What are you doing? Was that my pizza?
We're gonna take a quick break, and when we get back, Robin's gonna do the news.
Finalist number 6, No Signal, by Jason Sorokin from Ayer, Massachusetts.
Banana Corp, this is Duncan.
Oh, hi. Yes, your order is on the way.
Hello, hello.
How many can I put you down for? 4? 5? You only like 3 times? They come in packs of 4.
Gynacorp, this is Grace speaking.
Nah, you know, they're kind of too small to put a bottle in.
My name's Donald Davis, and I'm the manager here. To many people, 9/11 2001 was the worst day of their lives. For me, it was 1906.
First you say no signal, then you say acquiring signal, no signal, not the same thing at all. They're entirely different is what they are. But you say acquiring signal to me all the time, and you're saying acquiring, acquiring, crying. Before you said no, but now you're saying acquiring, they're not the same thing. I know they're not the same thing. I'm gonna have it, I'm gonna have it. It's gonna be fine, it's gonna be fine. I'm gonna have it. God, let me have it.
Stern. Yeah, my employees are obsessed with the shock jock. Personally, I find him disgusting. Not a big fan of the Jews. Go Jesus. I prefer listening to Don Imus and Rush Limbaugh. I've lost control of my team, and I have to get them back. I have to adapt. And that's why I'm taking Stern 101.
Ba, ba, boo, a?
Ba, ba, boo, a.
Fa, fa, fo, e.
It's a tough one.
In a high voice, who's
high pitch? Bullshit. I'm ready. Let's do this.
Hello, hello.
Wake up, white people! These filthy savages are ruining this country!
God, did he do
this? That's hot. I can't believe you just said that.
That's hot.
Oh my God, that's so good.
Did he just call that guy a nigger?
Oh my God,
that's awful.
Who's high?
Donald Davis, my boss, cunty.
I've learned through my studies that the Stern Show does a lot of prank phone calls, and I think that's going to play to my advantage because I am really good at phony phone calls.
Peter Baxter, how can I help you?
Yes, I am very unhappy with my order.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear about that. Can I get your name, please?
Baba Booey, Baba Booey. Yeah, I am concerned about productivity. This company lost $9 billion last year, and it's my ass that's on the line.
It's better than rejuvenation.
I have to stay the course. I have to show these people that I am one of them.
I see what Donald's doing, and I don't like it. Things have been awesome around here, and he's fucking it up. God, I hate him.
Donald's the kind of guy you just want to hate fuck. I'd make him my little fucking power bottom.
I think I'm finally making some headway.
I see a little bit of fat right here. And you know what? These boobs are just low quality. Can you bend over a little bit?
I guess we're going to Brown Town, right? I'll go get the gerbil.
Wah, I'm on the floor. Wah.
Yes, your order is on the way.
Back to work.
35 units?
Hey, what's going on, Robbins? Josh,
do you have any sort of fan or...
Hello, hello.
Dry it off.
Is this gay?
No, that's not gay.
Is that gay?
Homo!
In retrospect, not the best idea. Since Howard invaded my office, sales are up 90%. I guess happy employees are productive employees.
I'd like to talk about my raise, Mr. Davis.
You little bitch.
Hello, Gynocorp. Alex speaking. Yeah, your order went out yesterday, yeah. Maybe we can get together for lunch. Right now? I'm eating a roast beef sandwich. It's really good. They put mayo in it, though, and it's kind of gooey. Yeah, I really don't like, I don't like getting into that roast beef sandwich and finding the mayo in there first either.
Hello, Gynocorp. This is Grace speaking. Yes, sir. Excuse me, you said it's too wet? That's funny, sir. We haven't, usually it's the opposite problem. Do you have any sort of fan or something that you could dry it off with? No? Okay. Maybe ignore it for a while. Don't do anything at all, and it'll get dry as a bone.
Finalist number 7, Eating Fruit Salad by Matt Street from Austin, Texas.
Hello. My name is Matt Street. JD is about to fall in love with me. And he's about to get me a job on the Howard Stern Show. And then, I'm gonna show him my wiener. I am creating a profile right now on a popular website. It's sort of a space on the internet where you meet people. And it just so happens that JD is the person that I'm trying to meet. Now you might be wondering, how am I going to make a quote-unquote straight man fall in love with me? Well, with the power of the internet, I am now a woman. That ought to do it. So I sent JD an email today, which was our first internet encounter, a very pivotal moment. And it said, Dear JD, I know you hear this all the time, but I'm a huge fan of the show. I listen all the time, blah, 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 blah. Here's the hook. I think you are so cute on the air. And I knew it. He fell for it. Here's what he says in reply. Well, you are even cuter off the air. I am just the happiest woman in the world right now. I am really depressed right now. I sent JD an email about 4 days ago, which he has not yet replied to, and it said, a friend and I will be visiting New York City next month, taking a vacation, and we were wanting to know if you would show us around the city. Have some drinks with us, maybe even show us around the studio. And I hardly know the guy on the internet. It just seems like it might have been a little too forward for him. I think I scared the badass off. Yes! I'm back in the saddle. I think JD's making me bipolar, by the way. Because if you can't tell, I'm manic right now. So, we had a conversation on a messenger program on the internet, and it's moving in a sexual direction. I'll show you. Take a look.
I know you want me.
Are you trying to stalk me?
Trying? I already am. What's the most wrongest thing you've done sexually?
My last boyfriend made me pee on him.
I watched the dog lick a girl's pussy over a webcam once. You still got your webcam?
Wink, wink.
He's falling in love with a fictional character. Oh shit, he wants my number.
Give it to him.
Oh. Tonight's the night. I just got out of the shower where I shaved my legs and my ass. First, I'm gonna tuck my ween between my legs, get on the webcam, and show JD my vagina. Then I'm gonna slowly turn around and reveal my fruit salad. He should be pretty humiliated when he realizes that he's been hitting on a dude for the last month. Give me a minute, then you can see me.
I want to see you now.
Are you alone?
There's a camera near my office and I have glass doors, so I can't jerk off.
Finalist number 8, Degrading Henry, by Aaron Stubna from Coriopolis, Pennsylvania.
The fuck was that? Jimmy, Jimmy, wake up.
Why?
I don't know. I think I hit something with the car. Oh, shit. That fuckstick woke up. I told you.
Jesus Christ, pull over up here.
All my life, I wanted to be a gangster. I thought I'd be hijacking trucks, run a little gambling, bust a few heads, break a few legs. But the line of the industry we're in, this family, they operate a little differently. About a year ago, I get this call.
Oh my God. Hello, boys. Thanks for coming in. Oh my.
This is Danny.
You rascal.
I'd like to thank you for this opportunity, really.
William Shatner's lollipop is long and lengthy.
Come again?
Wang.
What?
Don't worry about it.
The boss is a little upset with Henry's past few visits to the show. He's been calling in drunk and make a complete ass of himself. We need to nip this in the butt.
You mean butt?
Wang.
What?
Here's where you'll find them. It's a little hole in the wall. Glory hole.
How would you like it done? Two in the head, in the face, cut out his tongue.
Oh no, boys. The ass.
Whoa, what's...
Whang.
What are we supposed to do with that?
Oh my.
Don't worry about it. Consider it done.
Now, boys, I'm gonna need that back now.
Oh, hey, you're kidding, right? You're kidding. We'll bring it back. I don't think I can do this. I don't think this is gonna. How are we gonna do this? How are we gonna pull this off?
What?
He's gonna be squirming around. That's disgusting. It's fucking disgusting is what it is.
I got it all under control.
I'm gonna get the bartender, slip a little GHB in his cocktail. Boom, he hits the floor, he's out. Forget about it.
It went down just like Jimmy said.
Hey, Henry!
Henry was at the bar. The bartender slips him the fuck drug.
Fucking cop.
Boom! Henry hits the ground.
Get that douchebag out of here.
We toss him in the trunk.
Oh, shit, I gotta pick up cannolis, too. Don't let me forget.
Now back to the ass rape.
Whoa! You're gonna break the car!
Jim, I will fucking pound this thing up your sister's asshole.
You're fucking losing it. Give me the dick.
I'm sorry. You got the dildo, I'll get the camera. Grab this cum chugger, let's get this the fuck over with.
Alright, get his pants.
I'm not getting his pants, you get his pants.
It's either that or this.
I get the pants.
Go ahead, he's ready.
I can't get it in. It just won't slide in.
Yeah? Spit on it, Jimmy. I don't know. What do you want from me? Jesus Christ, Jimmy. You can't spit in a dick hole. You gotta slather up the shaft with your mucus. Give me that. Here. You tape, I rape. Fuck!
What do you like to drink, huh, you fuck? Well, maybe this
will teach you not to drink on Howard's show, you piece of shit!
Ugh, fuck.
Are you fucking taping this?
Yeah, I'm taping it.
Hello.
Jeffrey, it's done.
Nice.
It's all taken care of.
You little bitch.
Whoa!
Balloon knot.
Oh boy, I shit my pants.
Let's go. Leave the dildo. Take the cannolis.
Hey now. Balloon knot.
Right, right.
Wake up, white people.
How big are your balls? Yes!
Hey now.
You little bitch.
Bubba Booey.
Hi, Daddy.
Oh my God.
Finalist number 9, Stern Revenge by Lee Vay from Shanahan, Illinois.
bring all the judges and contestants on stage, but seriously, how about another hand for all those movies? Come on, that's a lot of work. You guys, the judges want to come on stage, yeah. Those movies were pretty brilliant. I don't know, smart people listen to our show. Howard Stern, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
And Gage, we're going to bring the contestants up here?
Who else we have here? We're bringing up, man, I got to say something first of all. I am blown out by the creativity of this film festival. I expected, yeah.
In the kid one, when Fred does the fart noise.
You're brilliant.
That was unbelievable.
And I said to Robin, I leaned in during the middle of this thing, and I said, we should not have been judges. We should have left it to these three guys who actually know something about film, because I find it difficult to judge. That's how good they were. I expected a little shitty film festival with really crummy films, and I want to withdraw my film from the film festival. I don't
First
want
of all,
anyone to see it.
You can't withdraw your film. You said your film was good. But they were incredible, and I think we were maybe too close to the material they're covering to be objective.
Let's go through the films. You're going to call out Edna Mae Chamberlain for The Mating Call, which was the first film we saw with the incredible farting.
Oh.
Wow. Edna Mae. Edna Mae, how did you first hear about the film festival? And are you a student of film? Are you, you are an amazing director. How did you come to make this film?
I'm the executive producer, and I'm a big fan of the show, and I heard about the contest and decided that I'm the woman for you.
You're unbelievable. This was the film with the farting and all that stuff. Robin, what were your notes real quick without giving away too much?
All right, I like the theme. The fact that you told the story mostly with no words was amazing, that the farting spoke for itself.
Farting is
and
great, isn't it?
Once again, proving that farting is really funny.
Richard, what were your notes?
I'm reasonably certain in the history of Siskel and Ebert and Ebert and Roper, we've never uttered the phrase, the farting spoke for itself.
But now wait
Although that would be a hell of a blur.
As a film critic, were you impressed with the level of all the films?
Yeah, I could say that just from the start. I mean, every single one of these entrants, I believe, can have a career in film.
Me too.
Yeah.
Very good use. The technical level, I agree with Howard. I did not expect that. Although I have a feeling that maybe some of the ones that didn't make the cut, we would have seen that. Now, if you had looked at the contestants, if you had seen the finalists, that's probably the last person you would have thought would have done the fart movie.
I know.
I will say this. It's very, first of all, it's just tough to be first.
Yeah. Right.
I mean, there's nothing you can do about that in a contest like this. I mean, it's tough to be first. I think it's tough to be last. I did like it. I thought there was a moment, maybe about the three-minute mark, where we got it and we could have moved on to the next, whatever the theme was going to be, the back and forth. It was like the Dueling Banjos in Deliverance extended version.
So you're saying you felt it could have been shortened up a little bit and made stronger?
Or add a new element. And there were some things at the end that, again, brought it back. But just about the three-minute mark, I kind of felt like, okay, I get it. I get the back and forth. Maybe a little editing.
Bells, what was your quick note on that?
Well, I'm allergic to fart jokes, but this was the exception.
Yes.
And I agree with Richard. I think that could have been a little shorter, but I just found myself laughing out loud, which is rare in movies.
Yeah,
and that is, you know, that you can't fake.
That is very true. I was just laughing a lot on that one, and it's tough to get laughs, and the timing and everything else was pretty perfect, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And
I thought it was really well made. Again, I was really surprised with the level of all the films, just to say that in the beginning, because I was surprised with really the technical quality on all the films. This film in particular, in regards to the other film, I liked less. I thought that it needed to be edited and could have lost 2 minutes. I agree with Richard. But I think he did a great job, but I'm just being critical here. It's where we were called to take this seriously and give serious notes. I thought it was about 2 minutes too long. I got the joke. But I thought you did a great job.
Yeah, it was a great job. Great job.
Well, thank you.
Edna Mae Chamberlain. Next, we're going to bring out Eric Conner. Eric did the one with the puppet Tito Stern Left Behind.
Hey, guys, Jim.
Hey, Eric. Hi. Great job. Do you have something to do with the film industry? I mean, all these films are so great.
Yeah, I'm a writer and I teach at a film school.
All right, I'm going to go to Todd first. What'd you think, real quick? Just general impression.
I thought it was well made, very original, great idea. I thought you did a really, really good job with it. And being a big fan of Howard's for so many years and having heard that story, I really understood it, and I thought you did a great job.
Bells, what do you have to say?
Puppets can be funny, and I like that, you know, it was related to how you evolved into what you are today. So in that regard, it was true to what we're trying to do here. And, you know, it was...
Yeah, I thought the idea was unique.
Yeah.
Richard, what do you have to say?
Yeah, and I'm usually anti-puppetic, I must say. I'm not usually a puppet humor fan, but I thought you did a nice job with that. And, of course, the first film, when we're talking about theme, I mean, it just had that very, very, very tiny connection, really, to Howard's world. And, of course, this one really, really just immersed itself in that, and I appreciated that effort as well. Good job.
What's better in movies, farts or puppets?
Farting puppets.
Farting puppets Always. Are the king.
That was the band I was in the
Robin.
80s.
That's a real winner. I thought it was a great idea. But it struck me as more cute than funny, and I wasn't sure which way you were going. I thought it had some charm, but I didn't really think it hit funny.
Okay. Great job, Eric. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
Really, thanks for being in the film festival. All right, the next one was Blood on the Tissues. I got to tell you, I was really blown out by this one. I thought it was incredible. Let's say hi to James, Jimmy Gonzalez. What's your background? What's your background in film? How'd you get to be such a good filmmaker?
Oh, thank you. Actually, I'm a disc jockey producer by trade, but aspiring filmmaker. I decided to pick up the camera and kind of take my my creativity a little deeper. I don't know.
Yeah, it was pretty awesome. I like this one. I thought it showed a great sort of knowledge of the show. Using Heidi Cortez was a home run. And maybe you got a little drawn out in the middle. I kind of, as the guy said in the previous one, I got the joke after a while, but I just thought it was really well done and a novel idea. Robin, quick note on that.
I wanted to avert my eyes at the beginning, which is a good thing, but I said I have to look because I have to judge. It was very original, great use of the serious sound.
Thank you.
And part horror, part porno,
exactly.
Really good
exactly.
Mix there.
Richard?
Now, this is a true story. I'm walking down the street today, earlier today, and a guy yells at me, "Blood on the tissue." True story, right? And I thought, what does that mean? I thought some cult guy was going to grab me.
And now you know.
I was like, what is it? It was like Rain on the Scarecrow. I thought it was some sort of Mellencamp thing, Blood on the Tissue. And it was,
That was me.
That was you. And I called the authorities.
I'm
glad to see you're out.
I had to put it
like
in your head.
Dan Rather heard, what's the frequency?
It was my
Kenneth
own REM frequency, all Kenneth, right. A moment. I thought, first of all, the production level was top notch here. I mean, this looked like a lot of slasher films I see that are done by the studios. Very good editing. Very good up-to-date serious references, which I think is part of the criteria as well. I think you could have ended it a beat sooner than you did, so to speak. And I no pun intended, but I think it could have ended with the death. We didn't need to see the next thing with Jesus.
Bells, ready notes on this one?
Just that I like when you can scare someone and then make them laugh, and that he managed to do that, which is very cool for a
Todd,
movie experience.
Notes?
Yeah, I like how a lot of these films jump the genres. This was horror. There's some documentary things like the JD one. I like that you took a horror approach to it. I think you did a good job, but I agree with Howard. I thought it was a little bit long in the middle, dragged a little bit. It was a great job.
Yeah, but a strong film. Thanks for the entry, is really a great film festival. All right, Chris is next. Chris Pitchford did Trapped in the Attic. Wow. What is your relationship to film? Do you work in the industry?
Yes, in film school.
You're in film school? What film school do you go to?
It's not actually film school. It's San Jose State Radio, Television, and Film.
Well, you're doing a great job. I thought this
was
shot incredibly well. I thought it was really innovative, dangerous, eerie. And a great use of the show and just putting it in a whole different light. I gave real strong marks to this one. I'm going to go to Todd next. Todd, what'd you think?
I gave it really strong marks, too. Again, another horror film that I thought you did. It was a really smart idea and a great way to use the show. And it was actually a truly creepy film. You did a great job.
Thank you.
Yeah, it made me uncomfortable, which was good.
Bells, go ahead.
No, it made me uncomfortable, and sometimes that's good in a movie that somebody could transport you and grip you like that. I found it kind of icky and weird and compelling.
Yeah, I would agree with all of those things, which is a lot better than boring. I mean, there's obviously, some Pulp Fiction references there. I swear I heard Crackhead Bob say, "That's not nice," in the middle of this. If you can get a reaction like that from Crackhead Bob, so yeah, I think very effective. Very creepy.
Yeah,
very
Robin,
creepy.
Go ahead. What do you have to say?
Very disturbing. Is that what we do?
Yeah.
I think is that what you inspire? Is that what you inspire?
Whoa. It was very original. I liked it a lot because I really am a true fan of horror films. That was great.
Thank you.
All right. I'm going to move along now, and thank you for that great film. Did I skip one? I did. I did skip one. I'm sorry. I skipped... Radio Play. Wow. Unbelievable. I'm sorry I skipped it. Standing ovation. Wow. Radio, what could you say? Fabulous job, original. The kid who played Fred was cute. Robin was adorable, and Howard was masterful. I love seeing me, my king outfit. I love my father knocking on the door. Almost brought a tear to my eye when my father was telling me to shut up. Priceless, that's all I can say. Really brilliant, and I am proud that I'm here today. Autumn, right. Robin, go ahead. What do you have to say?
I couldn't take my eyes off it to write notes. I was so enthralled with the whole thing. It was charming. It was poignant. It really had the right feeling. And I loved it. I just completely loved it.
Richard, go ahead.
You know, I have to tell you again, everybody is so good, but kid, you're a filmmaker right now. You are.
Yeah, you really are. What is your background in film? I mean, are you
no doubt about that.
What do you do in film? Are you a student of film? How did you come to this?
Yeah, I went to school for film, and I work in film production in Boston.
Well, you're going
to
be a director, and you're going to be a storyteller.
Yeah, there's no question.
Thank you.
And I'll tell you something. You know, one of the key things here, and I know a lot of you guys, it was probably a struggle. You have to find people who can act. And child acting, you know, for kids to act. And these kids were so natural and so sweet. And I felt that this could have either run as the prelude or on the closing credits for Private Parts.
Really,
I could see that on the DVD.
I
think it would win audiences
well.
Over. I mean, it was just, and it just proves again, too. I mean, we saw a lot of gross out things, and that's fine. This was absolutely sweet. And it was really, really well done.
How long did it take you to make this film?
It was one long day of shooting, 14 hours. And
That's pretty amazing. Richard, go ahead.
I just think directing kids, as we all know, is an art form in itself. And the performances you got out of those kids was brilliant. And I don't know where you found them. And the fact that you did it in one day, it's a pretty incredible accomplishment. And I'd pay $8 to see your next feature.
Thank you.
Yeah, so would
Thank
I.
You.
Todd, what do you think?
I think it's, for a short film, it really is a masterpiece. There's some great films. This is, if you love Howard and you have, you know, I understand the show at all, this film was a masterpiece. It was well made. For me, it was clearly the best film, just saying. And the acting, again, was incredible. I just love the idea. I love the whole thing.
Yeah. Thank you.
Great job. Jason is next. Jason Sirodin, No Signal. This is really, really another great film. I began to feel like I was ashamed of my movie that I'm submitting tonight when I saw this. Shot really well. Lost me in a couple of places, but man, I was just captivated by it. I thought it was really good. I'm going to go to Todd on this one. What'd you make of it?
I really liked the idea, and I like you worked with a lot of actors, and I'm sure you did it in one day for no money.
One day.
And that was really impressive. I understand what Howard's saying in the middle. It lost me a little bit. I think some of these films, while the criteria was 5 minutes or less, they all felt like they were just at 5 minutes, and some of them could have been a little shorter. I felt like this was one of them.
Yeah, but a job well done. Let's go to Richard Belzer.
I was intrigued by what was going on and wanted to see what he was going to do next. I mean, even though it was a short, it was a little long, but the main guy just brought you into it, and I liked that there were so many people in it that you know, when you have a cast that big, it's hard to get an ensemble that delivered, but you managed to do it. It was really good.
Yeah, I got to say something. When I was watching this, it dawned on me that I don't think I gave a score below 7 or 8 on any of these films. That's
you're
how
like
strong
the
they
Paula.
Were.
Of
I'm the Paula Abdul.
Oh,
I learned something about myself. I learned that I'm going to be crying on American Idol if they ever let me judge.
You kept handing me a sheet. Can I write 11?
What was the lowest number you gave any film tonight at the film festival?
Probably a five.
What'd you think of this film?
First of all, I think very impressive. I mean, there had to be a lot of blocking and a lot of camera work there in a short film, that, moving all of that around. I think for a short film, you don't need all your credits in the first minute, because that'd be the equivalent of credits over the first 15 minutes of a feature. So it was a little busy in terms of the content, the credits, everything going. You're clearly a skilled filmmaker. I think you need to have, you know, more of a focus on your one main theme and be confident and stick with it, not try to throw too much in there.
Are you in the film industry?
Yes, I am.
What do you do?
I'm a TV producer for a television channel.
Yeah, great job. I mean, I was
Thank
blown
you.
Out by
Very
great
talented.
Production.
Thank
really
you.
Terrific. Thank you. All right, I got to stand up for the next guy. This is Matt Street. I got to tell you, another great film. This one's called Eating Fruit Salad, about J.D. Great job. Great job. Great job. I wrote one thing on my sheet on this one, great. And that pretty much sums it up. Here is a guy working alongside me, JD. I had no idea you pulled off this prank. The way you shot it, was that your penis, by the way?
It was. I'm looking for JD right now.
Yeah, where is JD? JD, come up and give him a kiss. Crying out loud. I mean, what a romance, how fabulous. Let's go to the guys on this. Let's go to Todd first. Todd, what'd you think?
I thought you made it was a great idea. I love the first-person documentary. It was like Super Size Me, but with JD. And I thought it was just so innovative. I would have liked to see some more prank films in the theme. Just phenomenal job.
Great job. Let's go to Bells.
I wrote one word on here, yes. I mean, this hit on all notes, and your acting was excellent. It's very naturalistic, cool style.
Oh, well, there you go.
And you're a college professor.
Richard, what'd you think? Yeah.
No, I was impressed by the whole thing, but I love your acting, if that means anything.
Yeah, very natural. Yeah. Richard Roper.
Yeah, I think Todd's reference to Super Size Me was apt. I mean, because you're a character, even though it's a documentary, just like Morgan Spurlock was in that film. You're a little creepy. Yeah. And I say that.
I find him sexy.
Well, you know.
JD's a little creepy, right?
It was. I thought we were going to see more documentaries. I give you credit for doing that. I think in some ways that's even a harder thing to pull off. And that last little line, you have a penis? There was still like a question mark. Like, I'm hoping you don't. I'm hoping you don't, but I think you do.
So, good job, JD.
Very, and a very nice story arc within a nonfiction film. I mean, we got it all in 5 minutes. Yeah. Very well done.
Robin, I take it you like this one, too.
I loved it. It was a little slow at the beginning when you couldn't get JD. A little slow for me. I wish that could have been tightened up a little bit. But once it got going, it rocked. You really rocked.
Really
and
did.
I loved it. It was very original.
And are you in the film industry as well?
Not at all, no.
All right, there you go. You're just an amateur, right?
Yeah, I never touched video before this.
You're kidding.
Really?
I just started on the show. That was my motivation.
You were great. Excellent. Thanks. Thanks for a great film. Big round of applause. Let's introduce Aaron Stubna. Aaron, hey, how you doing, man? He did Degrading Henry, which I thought was great, too. What a great concept to go after Henry Hill. I don't know, you'd have to be a Stern Show insider. If you were going to give a negative comment, you'd have to be a real Stern Show insider to know that this was Henry Hill and that Henry Hill was ass-raped. But since I'm a Stern Show insider, I loved it. The George Takei impression, priceless. Really excellent use of that. Let's go to Richard Roper. What did you think?
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, it takes a lot of guts, I think, to go kind of outside the real inside Stern family and do. And we saw some of those characters featured. Obviously, you're a huge fan of Goodfellas, and I think some of the freeze frames and things like that. I mean, nice little touchstones. This is the moment where it started hitting me that we were seeing way more male nudity than female nudity.
And funny.
Shame on all of you for that. Shame on all of you for that.
That's right.
But very well done.
All right, let's go to the Bells.
It's hard to send up a gangster movie because it's been done so often, but I thought this was a really cool take on Goodfellas, and I liked it a lot. It made me gag at the end, which I guess is good.
Todd, what'd you think?
Yeah, I agree. It made me gag at the end. I thought it was a super, super inside film, which I'm sure everybody here got, but it really
was.
I hope
so, yeah.
Yeah, and really good job. Well,
Robin?
I love that it took that little story to do, and I love that you did it in the Goodfellas style. It was great.
Very, very original to think of Henry Hill like that. And what about you? Are you a film guy? Are you in the business?
I'd like to. I took a couple night classes, but that's about it. I'm a barber.
What do you do?
I'm a barber.
Wow.
I cut hair, so.
Well, your
hair with those hands, with the hand that's holding that thing, you cut people's hair. That's great.
And obviously that's you nice. Cut your own hair.
I do.
Yeah. There you go. Big round of applause. Great job. Yeah. Our final film, and here I go sounding like Paul again. This is by Lee, and I hope you're saying your last name right. Vihi?
Vey.
Okay.
Oyvey's nephew.
Yeah, Oyvey's nephew. I wrote Brilliant next to this. This was Stern's Revenge, and I got to say, that was a great, great film and a real brilliant entry. When I first, sat around and thought about Mancow and how I wanted to skull fuck his father, I never would have imagined that they could have been the inspiration for a film. And I just want to say thank you for making my wildest dreams come true in film.
Literally.
Literally. I mean, it was just brilliant and well done and very creepy. Let's go to Robin. What'd you think?
I love horror films, and this was a great opening scene for a horror film. And I love... Did you go back and listen to one of those rants he did on Mancow? Because
He brings it up very often.
Well, but you remembered that he said, your father's going to be glad he was dead, because then I'm going to fuck you in the ass. Mm-hmm. So I love that.
Tremendous follow-up for Richard Roper. What'd you think?
I'm glad you love that. We've heard that about you before, Robin.
Maybe I can enter next year.
I walk into that.
It's the attention to detail. Attention to detail. What'd you think of the film?
A lot of skill on display here. Not my favorite theme, quite frankly, but I mean, the guy, you know what you're doing. You absolutely know what you're doing.
You mean to tell me you've never wanted to skull fuck somebody's father?
Yeah, I'm funny that way.
Yeah, I can't believe it.
Maybe an aunt.
Bells, what'd you think?
An aunt or a niece. I love the cutting in this. I love that, you know, in such short period of time, you create an incredible atmosphere. And I like Robin, I like horror films, but this is really true to the Howard mystique and legend, so it was a brilliant job and all. In every regard.
I got to tell you, the pacing on this I thought was amazing. In fact, there's only two films that I gave 3/10 to. This was one of them.
And the great soundtrack.
Same with me. There's only three films I gave 10s to. This was one. And what I love about this, having been a listener to Howard for so many years, the theme that I believe you touched on, which is such a big theme in Howard's world, which is revenge. And I just thought he did it so well.
Absolutely.
And it was, I wanted to see more. I wanted to see the other names. I wanted to see what happened.
Yeah, I need a sequel on that one. Yeah. I've got about 10 of them, actually, in mind. I want to thank every one of you. I am blown out by your creativity. Big round of applause for these guys. Yeah. Great. Great job, man. Great. Now, what we've done... We had all our judges add up. We're going to have their scores added up. I'm going to throw it back to Artie because now we have the staff films that we want to show to you. After the staff films, we'll announce the winner of the staff film one and then the winner between you guys. And you guys, once again, were great. Thank you.
Another hand for these guys. Come on. I just want to say, you know you're at a Howard Stern Film Festival when someone in the crowd yells at one of these brilliant filmmakers, homo. That was a nice touch. All right, while they're tallying up the votes, there were 2,000 films, over 2,000 films submitted. Not all of them made the cut. So we'd like to show you a little clip reel of some of the movies that didn't make the cut. Enjoy.
Hello, hello, Mary. I'm making this video in the hopes that you'll take me back.
Oh, crap. I gotta take a dump.
I'm fart, man.
I'd be honored to have you watch me take a dump.
I want pussy.
I will.
Get down! You maggot!
Take this!
Oh, forgot. Robin's feeding time.
Here you go, Robin.
So you want to have sex?
Sex? No, no, not right now. Put that magnifying glass away.
Party! Rocks with party!
Wah, I have a hot girlfriend, but she owns a dog. Wah!
$6,969! Fat fuck! $10,000 on the Giants with me over!
Fire! It's yet another soul-crushing defeat here at Giant Stadium. Texans 3, Giants 0.
Oh, baby, the way you sing my song.
Always a party with Artie.
Yes, it is.
about you?
No, guess you are. I may be a little bit surprised.
Baba, booey, baba, booey.
I had to fart, but I couldn't in front of her. So, I held it in. And I exploded.
Penny Crone reporting. In a shocking turn of events, Howard Stern has left Sirius Satellite Radio for rival XM in a two-year, $2.5 billion deal that stipulates he come alone.
My name is Robin Ophelia Quivers. I used to be wealthy. I used to own 8 cars and automobiles and horses and collect antiques. Now I'm emptying the urine for the indigent, showing my titty for $5. Oh!
I'm Ralph Sorella, man. I used to be famous, motherfucker. I used to do Howard Stern's hair, man. I used to let me call it on the radio show. Come on, man. Let me give you a blowjob for $10.
What's your name?
Maria.
Maria.
Si.
No, my mom always tells me I should always take off my hat when I'm talking to people.
Oh, que nice.
But I want to know where a stripper is.
Hello?
What you doing?
Chilling, watching the game, drinking my piss.
Sal, stop it. Twist my nipples like normal, you dirty bitch.
Did your mom ever pack butts like this, huh? You longshoreman, huh?
Oh, Sally, the only one that understands me. Sally.
Bop, bop, boy.
Bop, bop, boy.
Baba boy,
Baba boy,
Baba boy. Oh yes, the Baba boy. Oh Alibaba, no.
Baba boy.
Ah! Oh Allah.
Louis, I was wondering when you two might show up.
Hey, boss.
I was gonna bust your fingers and take your teeth out, gangster style. I warned you, right? I gave you admonitions. Gangster talk, right? That don't go down that way. I'll slap your fucking eyes out. Slap the fucking shit out of you, right?
I am not of this world. My people sent me here when I was just a young boy to turn all of you into mindless slaves, which seems to be an easy task.
Huh. You ate him out of business, Artie. Now what are you gonna eat?
I forgot how fun radio can be.
This is like an Olympic event.
Robin, you late for school. You get your sausage out your pussy.
Hey, boss, look at me, baby.
You do whatever you want with it.
Marriage?
hilarious.
All right. Let me just say this. You shit your pants once in a fucking pig outfit and you can't... Jesus. That was brutal. All right. The next thing... Wah! I shit my pants in a pig suit. Wah! All right. The next thing we're going to show, the staff movies. We all made movies. People in the show made films, and because Howard and Robin made them, they can't judge, so we have two additional judges. This first guy, you might know him from the phrase, Shock the Puss. Here's the deal. Ned. Bubba the Love Sponge. They sewed together three powder blue tuxedos. This next guy directed me in my sitcom debut on The Norm Show, and he has $2 billion from the show The Simpsons, and I'm going to stay at his house like Ralph for the rest of my fucking life. Here's Sam Simon. Sam is going to be busy later. He'll be fucking a supermodel on a pile of cash. I stole that joke from somebody. I don't know who it is. Anyway, Ralph Sorella was late with the movie. And we're letting him in anyway, okay? Everybody want to see Ralph's movie or what? Well, fuck you. You're seeing it. Ralph got it in. So here, without any further ado, are the staff films from The Stern Show.
Is a documentary about Ronnie the limo driver and his three sides, his work Ronnie, the scores Ronnie, and home Ronnie. I think I covered him pretty as good as I could, so enjoy the three faces of Ronnie.
Let's talk about Ronnie at work. He's a little twerpy Jew who thinks he's tough. But you know what? Goof on Ronnie all you want, the guy does a good job. He is a deterrent. He keeps things under control.
I know he gets irritated easily. He doesn't like to be bothered.
He's also, you know, when things are slow, he's also, you know, like the guy that hangs out at the corner, you know, with all his buddies coming by to talk to him. He loves when tons of people are standing around, you know, just shooting the shit, and, you know, he's in the center of it all. He loves being that guy.
Right. At work, Ronnie's all business. He puts on his Ronnie face, smiling, the laughing. When the guests come up, you know, he gets them into the room. It's a very serious Ronnie.
I love hearing him say, "Get out of here! Get out of my face!
Benji, get out of here!
What's your problem?
What is your problem?
What's the matter with you?
What's wrong with him? What the hell is wrong with him?"
love to see him get in a fight because he swears right. He can kick ass, but that, I don't see him kicking anyone's ass, to be honest with you.
Ronnie at Scores, that's a whole different guy. That's a guy without a care in the world.
He's like a kid in the candy store.
It's like crazy. It's like a total transformation from Ronnie to Scores Man.
Now that you know why they call me Scores Man.
He loves to be that guy that like gets the party started and tells the girls what to do.
Look at me. Look at me. Don't look at the camera. Look at me. This is what I tell you to do. Just look at me like you're madly in love with me. You want to fuck the shit out of me.
But we've seen Ronnie once or twice have too much to drink.
he's insane. There's something going on up there.
He's fun at Scores. Yeah. He's the guy you want to hang with.
And everyone there seems to really genuinely like him. I mean, you know, it's a funny act, but people seem to dig it.
I'm Ronnie, a limo driver known as Scores Man 93. We're closing in out, guys. We'll see you later.
Woo! I have no idea what Ronnie's like at home.
I don't want to know Ronnie at home.
The home Ronnie, very relaxed. You know, I've been over his house, what can I do for you? Can I get you a drink? This is great, blah, blah, blah. No problem, man, nicest guy in the world.
So this is my house, man, this is my place. Everybody wants to know about my NASCAR house. Well, this is it. This is my new addition to my joint down here. Yeah, y'all appreciate this. Now look, my stripper pole, we're gonna put this up. That's my dead dog with a tribute, you see? This is my workout room. This is where I get big and strong. See? Look. Look at that. Look at those guns. Look at those guns, as Elliot would say. Look at those guns. You don't see it under the suit. Hey, let me show you my bathroom. Yeah, this is like shit and piss. Yeah. Yeah, it's also got Tony Stewart all over the place. Impressed? Yeah, let's see what's on, if there's anything on. See, we got race day shit going on here, man. Don't want to be bothered today.
Is that what you want it to be? Three phases? That's what it is, man. I got home, then I got down. Wait, I got four phases.
Oh, yeah.
I got four phases.
Okay.
I got upstairs part of my house. That's the Ronnie, the quiet, the husband guy. Then there's the downstairs where I don't want to be bothered in my sanctuary here. And then there's Scores, which is, I'm not even going to tell you about. And then there's work. So you got four faces, man. You got a home run here.
Hi, you're about to watch a very inspirational, a very patriotic film. It's a true story about the courage of a man who's a power walker. It's a very inspiring movie for me to direct. I'm really proud of it. It's called Benjamin's Courage, a power walking story.
Hi. My name's Benjamin. I'm an Olympic power walker. I've known from a very young age that I was very good at power walking. Nobody took me seriously, but that just drove me to try harder. I knew power walking was my destiny. Back in school, I was being picked on by several bigger guys, some of them even black. and I power walked away from them. Something I soon realized was my ultimate goal was to power walk in the Olympics. After 5 grueling years of training, I contacted the Olympic Committee and I found out there is no power walking in the Olympics. I was crushed. But little did I know, 3 short years later, my life would be changed by one small white flyer.
Yes! 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 Yes!
I've hired the best power walking coach that money can buy. His name is Carlos Lobongo. And he really knows how to inspire me and motivate me to new dimensions of success. Without Carlos, I don't think I would have the confidence to enter the Morningside Nursing Home Power Walking Challenge. With each day comes a newfound respect for Carlos and his grueling work ethic.
Do you want this? Okay, carbo load!
No matter what happens in the power walking challenge, I know I gave it my all. And as a practicing Buddhist, I know every step of the way, Buddha will be walking beside me. And no matter who wins, I know as a professional power walker, my story will inspire hundreds, perhaps even thousands. My name is Benjamin, and power walking is my destiny.
I just want to welcome you to the film festival and say I hope you enjoy our film. It is the most talked about, the most controversial film of the whole festival.
And keep in mind, you have to have an open mind when you watch this movie and a very strong stomach. So, watch and learn.
There are 8 million people living in New York City with 8 million stories. This is one of them.
Siobhan, you look great today.
Thank you.
Do you know what I've got right here?
Is that what I think it is?
That's right. This is your ticket to womanhood. All I have to do is put my John Hancock on it. You'll have the surgery and you will become a woman.
Oh, goody, goody, goody. I'm gonna have a vagina. I'm gonna have a vagina. Oh, thank you, Dr. Cut My Cock Off.
Before I can do this, I've got to ask you a few questions, Siobhan.
Fire away.
How would you describe your life right now?
Well, I'd say that my professional life is a 10, but my personal life is more of a 2.
Only a 2? Well, according to the Del Bate scale, that only averages out to be about a 6. In order for me to sign this paper, you need to be at about an 8. What's going on?
When I was young, I knew I wasn't the most macho guy. But when I went to college, I decided I ought to at least try to be a man. So one night, I went out to a bar, I picked up this girl, brought her back to my dorm, and I screwed her. Afterward, I was so ashamed and disgusted with myself, I swore I would never ever use my penis as a man again, and I never did. But just last week, this girl who I had sex with 18 years ago gave me a call. She was dying. She was calling me from her deathbed to tell me that I had a son.
Siobhan, you're at a 6. Before I can sign this consent, you need to bring it up to an 8.
What do you mean?
Have you made arrangements to meet this young man, your son?
No, that's not possible. I'm getting my surgery a week from Friday. I don't have time for a son. I'm getting my vagina. Oops. I guess it's time for my hormone pills. Now, where were we? Doctor, what would I even say to him?
You could be honest. You could say, son, I'm going to have my cock and my balls taken off. I'm going to take the skin, I'm going to put it up me, and guess what, son? I'm going to have a vagina.
Doctor, why don't you just please sign the consent form? I don't want a son. I want my vagina.
She had a complete breakdown that afternoon, and much like Siobhan, it was ugly. It took a few days, but she finally realized the doctor was right. Before completely mutilating herself, she needed to talk to her son. So, she Googled her dead girlfriend's name and discovered she had a 17-year-old son named Toby. She found him on MySpace.com and arranged to meet him in Central Park the next day.
I can't afford to have bags under my eyes tomorrow. Toby, Toby, Toby. Will you be tall and thin? Will you be handsome? Luke, I am your father. I'm gonna be late. I have to create the perfect illusion of being a woman today. After all, today is the day that I will meet my little boy. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest one of all? Oh well, here goes. Toby?
Daddy? I knew you'd find me! I knew it!
About how its last day at the old-fashioned censored format and the effects it has on terrestrial radio. So here it is, my film, Death of Terrestrial.
Good morning, everybody. Well, this is it. This is our last day on terrestrial radio. This is the death of terrestrial radio. I don't think anyone's going to listen to terrestrial radio anymore. I really, really don't. This is the death of terrestrial radio.
Death of terrestrial radio.
Death of terrestrial radio.
My friends, end of the road is here. Thank you for the 20 plus great years on radio. Let the journey now begin on Sirius.
Hey guys, I know I haven't talked about it much on the show, but here's my little movie entry. So we've all heard of the commercials for Gatorade with Michael Jordan, Be Like Mike, where he teaches the kids how to play basketball and drink Gatorade. Well, my film is my version of that commercial. And if that sounds out of date, there's a reason for that. I shot this in 1994, so maybe this will be fun to watch. Here it is.
So my movie was inspired by Robin's revelation of her meats and vegetables and the way that she pleasures herself. I thought it was quite interesting, so I decided to take my perspective on it. So check it out. I hope you enjoy it. A lot of great surprises. Robin's Nervous Meat and Vegetables.
Lights, man.
Oh no. I can't handle another night of this. Oh no.
First, I'm gonna clean out my bowels, and then I'm gonna please myself with some meat and vegetables.
How did you get in there?
We
What a pleasant surprise. Here comes some company.
God damn. That girl's gone mad.
Hey, I think it's hot.
What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? Didn't you see what happened to the cucumber?
Who's the cucumber? What's your problem? I can't take this anymore! If I have to go up her ass one more time, I'm gonna lose it!
Look, my goodness, that was a fragrant one.
Holy mackerel, she's a-coming.
God, I can't bear to do this again!
Could that sausage be?
Pick the corn! The corn! Pick the corn! Pick the corn!
Yeah! Pick the corn! Pick me, please, Robin!
I really wanted the sausage. Grapes!
Oh, no!
I could make some really wonderful anal beads out of you.
Please don't pick me.
Shit!
What the hell? I'll try the corn.
Sweet!
Wish me luck, fellas.
That boy is crazy.
Oh, this corn is so wonderful.
We can't go on like this, man.
Fuck this place! Fuck some whores!
Will you cool it, man? This shit's gotta stop. The cucumber's a mess. She wants to stick them grapes up her ass. She's got popcorn coming out of her twat.
Woo! That was fantastic!
That was awesome!
I still need more meat and more vegetables.
No, not again, no!
Jesus Christ, why can't she settle for a normal prick?
Yo, that's it. Pricks!
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the pineapple, man. If we could get her to stick that up her cooch, those pricks are gonna tear her apart and she'll leave us alone once and for all, you dig? Yo, banana!
Hello, that would be me.
Grab that grape jelly. And what we're gonna do here is disguise that pineapple like an eggplant.
What, are you crazy? You don't make him an eggplant. I'm pineapple, gabish! Pineapple, you understand?
You're gonna be a fruit salad if you don't shut your trap.
Big beautiful time. Now you make him a melingana? Ha, well, Ben.
Ouch!
I am sorry.
Baba Banana, take it easy with the jelly.
Wow, what a big, juicy eggplant. But is it big and juicy enough for Robin Ophelia? Time to find out.
Let's have a bigger prick.
Ooh, this eggplant is incredible. Woohoo!
Look at that, Botana! Go! Chase it down!
Wow, that was the best orgasm I've ever had. Whoa, it's meat and vegetables forever!
Fuck this place! Fuck some whores! Oh!
And that's what's happening.
I don't want to introduce my film. The film speaks for itself. That's it. It's stupid to. I'm sitting here. Why do I have to introduce a film? You follow?
Keep it going for the staff films. All right. All right, let's get the staff up here. Come on, guys, with the new judges to be judged. And since I'm in this, I'm going to throw this over to your favorite producer, Baba Booey, Fafa Frohai, Gary Delabate.
Fire!
Thank you, Artie. All right, let's get our judges up here. We're bringing our judges up again.
Typically, the microphone doesn't work. No need to waste time. We should all go home in shame.
The one thing I did notice about the staff movies is you guys love putting your names in big letters right at the front of the movie. Right. Come on up, Sam. All right. As Richard comes up to the stage, everybody comes up. All right. So Bubba, what'd you think of the Ralph movie?
Typical Ralph pissed me off.
Why?
Left me hanging, and, you know, just a bunch of credits and shit.
I actually was sort of amused by it. It sort of hit Ralph right on the head.
He threw
in every friend's name that he knows. And
well, I want to take my name off of it.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. All right, the second movie. So JD's movie we've been hearing about forever. Todd, what did you think of JD's movie?
You know, they say documentaries are 80% subject matter. I think JD made a big mistake in his choice there. I thought it was a good film.
Yeah, you made a lot of documentaries.
Yeah, you got to pick the right subject. I don't know if Ronnie was it.
Yeah, the three faces of Ronnie might not have done it. Now, Richard Christie and his Benji Power Walking movie. Richard Roper, I'm going to throw this one to you.
Everybody can move down the stage.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. You know, it's a funny concept. Did you guys not get the fucking memo about 5 minutes? All you guys, you know, edit. Ralph's was still too long, even though it was an invisible movie and it was still too long. Funny stuff, Benji, you're overacting. Bring it down a notch, man. Bring it down. It's okay. You're funny enough just being Benji. And when you do that Benji squared thing, you don't need that.
That's what we commonly refer to as the Benji shtick coma. He does shtick and you can't get him out of it. All right, then we have the long-awaited Robin and Fred movie. Bells, I'm going to throw that one to you. What'd you think of the Robin and Fred movie? What'd you get out of that?
Check, please.
I thought it was odd that you guys parodied a movie that two people saw.
That's exactly what my notes say. Exactly.
Sam Simon, tell me, what did you think of the Doug Z. Goodstein movie? Again, giant letters across the front of it.
The Death of Terrestrial Radio.
The Death of Terrestrial Radio.
I thought it was okay. I thought it was one joke. And then I know he did slow motion or stop motion when all he had to do was pull the cord on it. radio, so he probably wasted a lot of time.
Yeah, I mean, I thought you guys, I thought overall the staff movies are pretty good, but, you know, none of you are filmmakers the way that first group were. I mean, those guys are amazing. Then there's the Artie Lang movie, and, you know, my buddy and I had I known I could submit movies I made in high school, I would have put one in. So let's throw it over to Richard Roper. What do you think of the Artie Lang?
I'll just read my notes. This was made in 1994, Artie, is that correct? So in 1994, Artie was an overweight, unshaven fuck-up with a drinking problem in 1994, and now...
He's changed.
Exactly.
Tremendous progress.
Very funny, actually, though, I have to say.
Okay, then we have Sal, his epic... And again, I want to point out for anybody that missed it, he did misspell vegetables in the title. Todd, I'm going to throw it over to you.
I think that when the people at Pixar see this film, they're going to steal the idea. It was just like a Pixar movie with all the celebrity voices. I thought you did a great job, Sal.
And finally, we come to the Howard movie. Bubba.
Why are you going to ask me?
You know what? Forget, Bubba.
I work for Howard. I'm not in it. My name's Bennett, and I'm not in it.
Let's throw it to Richard, because I already know you love it.
All right. Go ahead, Richard.
Which
ahead,
dick?
Let's go to Richard Roper first.
All right. Well, my question for Howard is, did you make this movie? Did you really make this movie?
Yes, I did. I conceived of this movie. I was in a coma at the time, and I don't know what I was thinking. But, you know, I want to explain my movie just somewhat. That is what I see every morning. I look over at Fred, and that's what I look at. And I wanted to give you my vision of what I do.
I think it really was more, Howard's obsession, it should have been called, instead of about Fred. But I actually think that... I think Ralph put more effort into his movie, quite frankly, than you did, Howard.
I thought mine gave insight to the fans.
Don't argue with the judges.
I argue.
We were actually wondering, Fred, you were expecting way worse than that, weren't you? Were you expecting a movie way worse than that?
For what? Absolutely. I expect you. Thank you. I see there was a pattern here tonight, so I'm having the microphone taken away from me because I don't speak well. So.
You know, Fred, I've been trying to control your microphone forever, and it's just impossible. Here it is, back again.
Now, I think everybody did a great job.
Everybody did a great job, too. I can't say shit because I didn't submit anything. Guys, do we have the results? Are we ready for the results of the staff movie? Or they're still putting them together. So, Artie, come on out here and be funny.
Thank you, Gar.
Hey, Artie, tell me a joke.
I think it was great that Howard made a movie that everyone can relate to, what he sees every morning.
At least mine was short.
Mine was like a minute.
At least his was made this year.
Yeah, I love that Artie made a movie when he weighed 170.
I'm a busy guy.
I just want to compliment Nicole Bass on her acting. I've never seen anything like that. It's really awesome. While we're waiting for the results...
I've got them.
All right, I just wanted to say thank you to everybody. I thought this was a real fun night, and it goes to show you, it's true what I always say, the audience is way more talented than we are.
All right, I have the results of the staff contest, which... I'm going to start out by telling you who came in dead last. I'm not going to give you everybody. I'm going to tell you who came in dead last. And it's so fitting. In dead last, with a zero for effort, is Ralph Sorella.
I thought Ralph's was great.
I actually liked Ralph's. I did. I liked it. It was a good concept. Okay.
A lot of effort.
In third place, because you're all a bunch of brown-nosed bastards, Howard's movie came in third place.
Thank you.
I know I knocked it down to a bronze then.
Okay.
I gave it a 10.
The second place movie made in 1992 was Artie's movie, came in second.
They didn't have any devil dogs in Artie's movie, though.
And the winner of the staff award is actually a tie. And it's a dead heat. It's a tie, and I'll tell you right now, Sal, you're going to be heartbroken because you're not the one. You're not one of the guys who tied.
Wow.
You didn't make it. The winner... The winner of the staff award is Robin and Fred's movie and Doug Z. Goodstein's movie.
Wow, it ties.
Doug Goodstein's movie. Yeah, I'm not sure I get it either.
You know what? I was going to say. For a second, I would like to give my award to Sal because I think his was the best movie. I don't know what happened to the judges. They must be punch drunk or something. Were you guys drinking? Oh, my God. Sal, you did a great, incredible job. And
thank you.
You take the award.
No, I just want to say that...
I just want to say that we're running behind.
Okay, thank you very much, everybody.
All right,
thank you, Howard.
At this point, I'm going to ask Bubba and Sam to step off the stage. Judges, stay here. Robin and Howard, come and sit down. Staff, let's give a big round of applause. Thank you. And now we're going to bring out the nine finalists for the regular Howard Stern Film Festival. So staff, you can step off. Finalists, you can all step on. And I'm going to throw it over to you, Howard.
Why are you throwing it to me? I'm exhausted. What time do I get up in the morning?
What time do we have to be out of
first
here?
First of all, we have to get out of here because someone else has to load in. And that would be, again, fitting for the Howard Stern Film Festival. I want to thank all of our judges for doing this tonight. This was really great.
Thank you.
The fact that you would waste your time with us. Well, again, you guys are great filmmakers. Where are the results? Fa, fa, flo, fly? Doug C. Goodstein. Doug, you want to give me the results so that they can start loading in for the Santana concert?
Ganji is coming up with
the results.
All
right, here we go. All right, here we have the results.
I'm anxious to find out.
Well, let's see. Oh, my God. Good night, everyone. All right, I should do it like Ryan Seacrest, shouldn't I? All right, first I'm going to break you down into 17 different groups and make you crazy. All right, I'm going to ask the following two people to step forward. Eric Conner and Etta Mae Chamberlain. Step forward, please. I'm going to ask you, Etta Mae, to take one step backwards. Hold it. Simon didn't say one step backwards. No. Actually, Eric, you were in last place with Tito Stern left behind. I'm so sorry. And Etta Mae, with the mating call and the farting, which I think was so brilliant, was second to last. I was shocked. Shocking. Shame on all of you.
That means they're ninth out of 2,200. Though.
That's right. Let's remember that. There were over 2,000 entries. Over 2,000 entries. All right, I'm not going to jerk you guys off. The next film, I guess you could say, I might as well just go to third, second, and first place. What do you say? Because we have to load in. In third place, maybe we'll do it like this. I'm going to ask... All right. In third place, eating fruit salad, Matt Street. Come on, Matt. I thought that was a brilliant film. Congratulations. And Matt, this check for $2,500 is yours, and are there additional prizes and all kinds of crap and stuff? And I just want to thank you for making that great film. You made this a great film festival. If you want to make a little speech.
I'm just glad my ween is easily fashioned into a vagina. And that JD is such a pervert. Couldn't have done it without JD.
Yeah, let's thank JD for that one. In second place, the runner-up to the entire film festival, Levi Stern Revenge. It was great. I love that film.
I made it for you.
That was the one where I was having sex with a skull, isn't it?
That is the one.
So I'm going to play that on a continuous loop at my house. Congratulations on your check and coming in second place. Great job.
Thanks again.
Well, in first place with a score of 145 points, it doesn't surprise me, really. This was a great film, and they all were great. But, Scott, you really, you shine. Scott Masterson, Radio Play. Great job. Congratulations.
No argument here. No argument.
Great job. Here's the check for $15,000 in cash plus additional prizes, all over $30,000. You want to say something?
I just want to thank everyone that helped me out, the cast, the crew, especially John Rebella, who played Howard, and that's John's mom up there. And just thank you for this opportunity, Howard. I think I speak for all the filmmakers when I say there's not a lot of opportunities like this out there, and we really appreciate it. Thank you.
Right. I think it was a big success. Congratulations. I want to thank everybody. You guys all did great. Thank the judges. Thanks for coming. Let's hope we do this again next year. It was a great film festival. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks for watching the Howard Stern Film Festival. See you next year.